been trying to level up, you know? Promo. Clap on the promo. Hopefully that, what is, I don't know what that means. Midnight streamer. Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah. For the foreseeable future, that's probably gonna be my thing. Fire, and even last stream, somebody helped inspire the idea for the pineapple as a power up. And I'm probably gonna have oranges as a power up too. I don't know what it's gonna let you do, but if you have apples, you gotta have oranges in the game. So, what this is doing, in a nutshell, it's spacing the apples out so they don't spawn like stacked on top of each other. For some reason, it's still happening sometimes. So I'm increasing the distance to see if that makes a difference. But, like, what we're gonna do, maybe I want to have like, I'm thinking having like an aura around the player, like a some bright aura to let you know, like kind of how I do with the bandana. You have this like flashing particle effect. Again, like I'm not avoiding the apples coming close together. I think that's fine. I just don't want them stacked on top of each other. It looks like that might not have fixed it. Those apples are kind of close. Dev streams will still be done after the game releases. Oh yeah, of course. I'll be adding updates. Once the game releases though, I'll probably be doing other types of development streams. I have some ideas for a basketball RPG that I've had for years that I plan on like doing. I don't know what that's gonna turn into, if it's gonna turn into an app, a game, or whatever, but I have way too many ideas for that for it not to be development work. And of course, I'll be working on condensing some of these streams down into videos, YouTube videos. So that'll be fun to check out on the channel just to get quick updates. And I'll probably be developing like shorter projects, stuff that we can do and finish in a stream, stuff like that. But yeah, to answer your question, yeah, I'm still going to be doing dev streams. Wow. I don't know how I just typed in Midnight Club. Driving games used to be hard, especially in arcades. Well, the arcade games, they're made for you not to win. But driving games used to be tough. I'm just using a ray list. I don't really, yeah. Because I'm not getting the apples when, how do I describe this? I'm not collecting the apples in order. Even though they're getting spawned in order, the link list isn't really saving me much time. If anything, it's slowing us down. We're gonna do ananas. Yep. Pineapple. I was thinking about calling ananas scripts, but I'm gonna forget what that means. I'm gonna be very confused. We didn't make the collision logic for it yet, so it shouldn't be able to be interacted with, but it should appear. I may have missed something. Let me get to 50 apples so we're sure that, I got 2 clocks, no pineapple. The thing is, it's possible for consecutive clocks to spawn. It's just a really low chance that it will happen until you collect a lot more apples. Oh, stream is good now? Okay, thanks, good to hear. Oh, maybe I'll add a play music fast. Yeah, okay. That should be cool. Oh, you know what'd be cool? Instead of making you like invincible, or it could basically work like the Mario Star where you're just breaking through all the asteroids and the lava without being touched, instead of you phasing through them, which is what I was originally gonna do. How many asteroid sprites? Yeah, I didn't know which one I wanted to use for this game. Like, I didn't know, like, which ones looked the best, and I just decided on the ones we're using now after some time. We should see a pineapple come up soon. We just expect to be able to grab the pineapple. It won't do anything right now, but... cool. So it was gonna spawn a pineapple, but it didn't have one. It gives the asteroids variety. Use all asteroids. Yeah, I might. I might. Oh, you mean like randomize it? Maybe. Okay, nice. We got a pineapple. So I should be able to grab it. It should destroy when I touch it. Nice. So there's no pickup effect for it. So what I'm thinking about doing is... I need to have it distinguish the like particle effect. It has to be, it has to look different from the banana. Nice. This is exactly, wow, I'm so glad we did this. Like, I wanted to highlight the fact that, you know, your feet are given that power, not your whole body, like your legs, your magic mic in the feet and nothing else. Okay, I want to make it a little closer to you. I may make small like changes or stuff where like maybe you don't have consecutive power-ups, although you can. That's not the worst thing. If you just have, because you can strategize when you pick up power-ups. Like for me personally, I don't like to pick up the clock power-up unless I need it, because it's really strong in when you're stuck in higher levels. How are you up? It slows everything down. The higher you are, the more points the apples are worth. Ooh, that's interesting. That's interesting. Like maybe the higher up apple, or maybe that's actually a good thing. I don't know if I'll do that in this first update because I want to get everything working and ready. But what I really, based off what you said, DJ, is we could do like, we could spawn special golden apples that are impossible to collect, or not impossible, normally impossible unless you have the banana. And then you get like 10 points or like all your health back. That's a good idea. I'm going to make a note of that. Great suggestion. We'll still keep the asteroid hit. Or maybe we'll add a new sound. Maybe we'll do the apple collecting sound. How does Mario do it? When you collect a star and you run through items. Let's quickly check. Sound. Get the star. So it's like the same music you get when you jump on the Goombas, right? Yeah, so let's have the apple hit music here. If you have the pineapple power, what you're going to do is have the apple collected music play. Right? Yeah. And I think that is it. I may have forgotten a bunch of things, but let me reiterate quickly. This game is named Apples and Asteroids. It's going to be out on Steam for PC on October 24th, and it's a game that I've been working on and off for the last 2 years, and the game is entirely made up of pixel art assets that I've created, as well as music made by my good friend Rami L Music. And yeah, we've been live streaming it this week, development of it. Oh, okay. For whatever reason, I guess I don't know why I have to attach it here, but it looks like this is what I need to do. Attach it to the player. That's strange. Resimulate. Yeah, nope. 10. Whoa. I don't want to cause any. Whoa, that looks like turning Super Saiyan or something. Fidget, yeah, it's too much nervousness. Like, it may feel like it just makes you anxious for no reason. Yeah, let's increase the duration. I don't know why I don't understand the emission. What's going on here? Sphere. Is that what I'm looking for? It's like going in a clock, though. Is it because of the mode? Oh, it's because of the mode. That's what it is, I think. Wait, no. We do random? Yeah, I like that better. Now let's move up the radius. To 0.8. Yeah.
So I'm gonna make like a for loop of like, if you try 1,000 times,
and there isn't a valid apple position, what we're probably going to do is just go with. It's fine if they stack. Bug fixes are so important. Like, to me, they're just as important as all the features we add, because no matter how great their game is, a bad bug can ruin it, no matter how good it is. Bugs make it not fun. Well, sometimes you can abuse bugs and it makes it fun. So sometimes it's positive, but if it's a bug that's just like always happening, or even if it happens once, especially when you're trying to break a worldwide high score or a global high score, let's say you get 200 apples and then a bug happens, man, I'd be upset for you. Yeah, that's pretty much it for me. Thank you all for tuning in. Appreciate the feedback, the comments, the jokes, everything. It was really cool working on this midnight streaming thing. So, and yeah, I will be back tomorrow. So hopefully you guys all take care. Happy birthday again, DJ. And